Hello students, I am Dr. Prakash. Welcome you all for the online class on International Marketing Strategy. The second module in the syllabus is Global Information Systems and Market Research. To start with the introduction, it is very important to understand the importance of information technology and marketing information system. It is required to utilize a framework for information scan and opportunity identification. It is also essential to understand the formal market research process and to know how to manage the marketing information collection system and market research effort. Given the variety of languages spoken around the world, along with the cultural differences, it could be difficult to conduct global market research. It is the marketer's good fortune that a veritable cornucopia of market information is available on the internet. A few keystrokes can yield literally hundreds of articles, research findings, and websites that offer a wealth of information about a particular country's markets. Even so, marketers need to study several important topics to make the most of modern information technology. The information technology refers to an organization's process for creating, storing, exchanging, using and managing information. The managing information system provides managers and other decision makers with a continuous flow of information about company operations. An MIS should provide a means for gathering, analyzing, classifying, storing, retrieving and reporting relevant data. The MIS should also cover important aspects of a company's external environment, including customers and competitors. Global competition intensifies the need for an effective MIS that is accessible throughout the company. The important tools of MIS are intranet, electronic data interchange, efficient consumer response system, and electronic point of sale. The first one is intranet. So it's a private network. It allows authorized company personnel or outsiders to share information electronically. It will have a 24-hour nerve center, and it allows companies like Amazon.com and Dell to operate as real-time enterprises. The real-time enterprises model is expected to grow in popularity as wireless internet access becomes more widely available. The second one is electronic data interchange. It allows the business units to submit the orders, issue the invoices, and conduct business electronically. The transaction formats are universal in nature, and it allows computers from different companies to speak the same language. For example, Walmart is legendary for its sophisticated EDA system for years. Vendors have received orders from the retailer on personal computers using dial-up modems connected to third-party transmission network. In 2002, Walmart informed vendors it was switching to an internet-based EDA system. The switch saves both time and money. The modem-based system was susceptible to transmission interruptions, and the cost was between 10 and 20 cents per thousand characters transmitted. Any vendor that wishes to do business with Walmart in the future must purchase and install the necessary computer software. And the third one is efficient consumer response. It is a joint initiative by members of a supply chain to work toward improving and optimizing aspects of the supply chain to benefit the customers. This is in addition to the EDI and an effort for retailers and vendors to work closely on stock replenishment. It utilizes the electronic point of sale. The electronic point of sale uses data gathered by checkout scanners to help retailers identify product sales patterns and how consumer preferences vary by geography. The other one is customer relationship management. So it's a new business model. The philosophy used in this is that it values two-way communications between company and customer. Every point of contact with the customer is an opportunity to collect the data, and it can make employees more productive and enhance corporate profitability. The CRM tools allows companies such as Credit Suisse, AT&T, and HP to determine which customers are more valuable and to react in a timely manner with customized product and service offerings that closely matches customer needs. If implemented correctly, CRM can make employees more productive and enhance corporate profitability. It also benefits customers by providing value-added products and services. A company's use of CRM can manifest itself in various ways. Some are visible to customers, others are not. Some make extensive use of the technology, leading edge information, others do not. A visitor to Amazon.com who buys a U2 CD encounters CRM when he or she is prompted by the message, "Customers who bought this title also bought another title from the same person." One challenge is to integrate data into a complete picture of the customer and his or her relationship to the company and its products or services. This is sometimes referred to as a 360-degree view of the customer. The challenge is compounded for global marketers. Subsidiaries in different parts of the world may use different customer data formats, and commercial CRM products may not support all the target languages. In view of such issues, industry experts recommend implementing global CRM programs in phases. Now, there are some issues related to customer relationship management. For example, European Union's Directive on Data Collection in the year 1998 ensures regulations of all 27 members. The US and the European Union's Safe Harbor Agreement, which was entered into in the year 2000, protects individuals' rights among the nations. So in this, the Safe Harbor Agreement establishes principles for privacy protection for companies that transfers data to the US from Europe. The purposes of the information collected and used here: an opt-out option to prevent disclosure of the personal information, and it can only transfer information to third parties that are in compliance with the Safe Harbor, and the individuals must have the access to information. The privacy issues vary from country to country. In the European Union, for example, a directive on data collection has been in effect since 1998. Companies that use CRM to collect data about individual consumers must satisfy the regulations in each of the European Union's 27 member countries. Then we have data warehouses. It is an integral part of CRM. It helps fine-tune product assortments for multiple locations. It enhances the ability of management to respond to changing business conditions. So the company personnel, including persons who are not computer specialists, can access data warehouses via standard web browsers. Behind the familiar interfaces, however, is specialized software capable of performing multi-dimensional analysis by using a sophisticated unit techniques such as linear programming and regression. This enhances the ability of managers to respond to changing business conditions by adjusting marketing mix elements. MicroStrategy, an information service company in the UK, is one of the several companies creating data warehouses for clients. As manager Stuart Holmes explains, many corporations have a vast amount of information which they have spent money accumulating, but they have not been able to distribute it. The web is the perfect vehicle for it. Now let's move on to the organizational information technology necessities. An efficient, effective system that will scan and digest published sources and technical journals are very essential. Daily scanning, translating, digesting, abstracting, and electronic input of information into a market intelligence system is also very essential. Expanding the information coverage to other regions of the world. Now let's move on to the sources of market information. So there are personal sources and the direct sensory perceptions. Personal sources include the company executive based abroad who have contact with distributors, consumers, suppliers, and government officials. It also includes friends, acquaintances, professional colleagues, consultants, and prospective employees. Under direct sensory perception, using the senses to find out firsthand what is going on in a particular country. So often, the background information or context one gets from observing the situation can help fill in the big picture. For example, Walmart's first store in China stocked a number of products, extension ladders, and giant bottles of soya sauce, for example, that were inappropriate for the local customers. Joe Hadfield, Walmart's top executive for Asia, began roaming the streets of Shenzhen in search of ideas. His observations paid off when Walmart's giant stores in Dalian opened in April 2000. A million shoppers passed through its doors in the first week. They snapped up products ranging from lunch boxes to pizza topped with corn and pineapple.